There's a world of difference between Tunisia and Libya. One reason I'm somewhat optimistic or hopeful about Tunisia is that Tunisia is a homogeneous country. Tunisia is a small country. Tunisia has traditions of reform. In the mid-1990s, you had Hariri, Basha, a Tunisian, who wanted to learn from the European experiences and to develop Tunisia. Tunisia, by the way, abolished slavery in 1846, 17 years before the United States of America, and it did not require them the bloodiest civil war in their history, and we did it in this country after not only the bloodiest war in American history, but the bloodiest day in American history, because the Emancipation Proclamation was issued by my man, Abe Lincoln, following the Antietam, which is the bloodiest day in American history. I'm a Civil War history buff, as you can tell. So Tunisia is different. The secular traditions of Tunisia that were brought about by the first president of Tunisia, a man who was maligned later, and as a young man, I used to demonstrate in the street of Beirut and malign him. This is Habib Bourguiba. And now we look back at Habib Bourguiba and we yearn for people like Habib Bourguiba. Habib Bourguiba enacted universal suffrage in Tunisia in 1957. 1957. Universal suffrage in the United States was in 1920. So that tells you something. Abolished polygamy, gave women equal rights when it comes to divorce. He looked jaundicely, as I do, and forgive me, this is on the record, on Ramadan, when people don't work in Ramadan. He didn't like the fact that people, you know, should not be unproductive in the whole month of Ramadan. So we had these traditions, which makes Tunisia somewhat similar to Turkey. And a history, a polity that is more open, more tolerant. Women were more educated. The economic development of Tunisia is much better than neighboring countries. So that's one of the reasons why Tunisia may make it.